So very, very excited for season two. I absolutely love this show and excited to see more of you guys together. I have to say you guys are one of my favorite little couples. I feel like it's very cute whenever they're on screen together. So Steve, speaking about Corliss, obviously for him last season, I feel like a lot of his sort of ambition and his goals are tied to his legacy. And obviously Lucerys is dead, who is his heir, and he's lost his children. How much of Luke's death, plus the death of all his children, is going to affect this idea of legacy for him in this season?
It's, I can't think of the right word, but it's very important as a motor for how he goes through season two and what he chooses to do. Because he is, bereft is too strong a word because his wife is still there, but he is bereft in the sense of my plans have all gone. This is how, this is not supposed to be how it works. Beginning of season one, he's like, my daughter will marry this person, my son will marry this person, and the family name will be secure. And now that's all been wiped asunder. So part of his actions in season two are partly trying to reconcile that and also trying to find somebody who can take that place. There's a point where we have a discussion about the children that are available, in terms of his granddaughters. And it's, first of all, it's like a woman. And then it's like, well, she doesn't know anything. Oh, I think there's a young boy, so like, he doesn't know anything about ships. What's going to happen? So, despite the fact that he is aware that his ambition caused an awful lot of the destruction that happened to the family, he is still the same man. He still believes that the family needs to be secure. This is a world in which you can be easily wiped out. So he still feels that he has to do that. Tries to go about it.
I look forward to seeing where that progresses. And then Eve, I think there was some talk in the first episode that we've just screened, about sort of Rhaenys not taking the chance when she had it in season one to sort of wipe out Aegon's line. Do you think there's any
Why is everyone so bothered by that? It's so funny to me.
Well, I'm curious if there is any regret now that because Lucerys is dead and that's a family member to her. And if there's any sort of, does she look back on it with regret, or is it like, no, she knows that what she did was right?
I don't think she does look back on it with any regret at all. It was absolutely the right thing not to start a nuclear war. I mean, the fact that Lucerys is dead is appalling. It's just, undescribable grief. At this point, though, it feels like she's holding so much of the bigger picture for everybody else who's going through their own private unraveling. And actually, she's the only one, pretty much through the season, who's saying, look, guys, there is a bigger picture that we need to pay attention to, which is we must not have nuclear war, and that the thing most hateful to the gods is a war between dragons, and it's the most devastating and dangerous thing, unimaginable thing that could happen, and that's necessary to avoid at all costs.
And there is sort of like an elephant in the room, I guess, when it comes to Corlys and Rhaenys, which is the fact that I think they don't realize that their son is still alive out there in the world, and that he's potentially just roaming out there. I'm curious if any of the feeling these two characters' feelings for, I guess Daemon and also by proxy Rhaenyra would be different if they knew the truth
Oh gosh,
of
so
where they
much, I
are.
think so much.
Yes, I think so. Yes, I think so, but yes, well,
I think,
because obviously those two are implicated in his death. So of course it would change in that sense. But I think even as you were asking the question, I was thinking, I wonder, let's imagine he came back. You might start questioning what kind of life we had created for him that meant he had to do that, had to fake his own death and leave, particularly in a family with a father who is so about duty. And because we have a scene in episode in season one when, of course, when you say, he's not the type to marry, something like that, and I go, well, he'll grow out of it because I don't really care about him. I want this for my son. But I think, but yes, if he was alive and they knew he was alive, it would, yes, of course, it would change how they felt about those two. but not much.
I think you're right, actually. I agree with you that it would change. I mean, that elephant, if that element was soothed, that elephant, it would be a big deal for Rhaenyra, because I think that's, for Rhaenys and Rhaenyra, that's been a very much an unspoken question mark between them. And it would clear Rhaenyra's name up to a point, which would be significant. But I think deep down, there's some other, there's deep undercurrents of, you know, complicated and rather murky feelings towards both of them that we both have, that I'm not sure could be just easily resolved by the return of our son.
Yeah.
Although it would be a start, but I don't think their characters would suddenly be wiped clean.
No.
I don't think the slate would
not
be
yet. Not yet.
Perfect.
Right. I mean, there's a lot to deal with on that front. Yeah.
They're curious. They're a dodgy pair. Let's face it.
As two actors who played in season one, you guys were there for the entire season and you worked with the younger cast and also with the current cast now. And coming into season two, did you feel a shift in how the show was operating now that you guys are more stable? You know, there's not so much change and fluidity, or has it been largely the same?
I think it's been different only in the sense that for us as actors, as work colleagues, a lot of season one, we were all together. Mm-hmm. But it is necessary. Season two has necessarily split us up because, of course, two factions and they're going to go to war. Mm-hmm. And so we necessarily were separated from our colleagues in that sense. I worked mainly with Eve and a couple of other new actors. I think maybe one or two scenes with Emma. But for example, Fabian, Olivia, Olivia, Matt,
Tom, you, and all the green characters.
We never saw them. Do you know what I mean? So in that sense,
it's just a shame.
Yeah. But for people for our execs who have seen all of them, they all say the show is much more epic and much more Games of Thronesy. That's a word.
It felt like a slightly steadier ship. I mean, the first season that we were filming, we had COVID. It was, you know, everybody was under so much pressure coming, doing this, you know, nobody knew what it was that we were making.
Yes.
I think there was a lot of fear and a lot of uncertainty and a lot of chaos. It was all, you know.
That's right, yeah.
And now it just felt it did feel steadier in a way. It felt calmer. Yeah.
Because we didn't know how it was going to go, because of course they'd had a pilot that they'd made as another offshoot of the show, and for whatever reason it wasn't successful, so there was no guarantee that this would be. Whereas of course coming back into it, having been a success, that's a different kind of pressure, and as Billie Jean King said, pressure is a privilege. But it was still kind of nice coming back thinking, oh well, you know, we did okay first time round, so...
Sitting on laurels.
No, they've raised the bar.
Well, that's fantastic. Just wrapping everything up, I want to thank you guys for speaking with me. But just one final little thing. If you guys could play as actors, characters on Team Green, not Team Black, who would you pick?
I think, for me, the most intriguing character on Team Green, and I don't think he got enough plaudits for his performance, I thought it was fantastic, I would love to play Otto. I just love what Rhys did. I love that character so much. Yeah.
Does. Still does.
Still does. Yes. Indeed. What about you?
Well, I think I'd love to play any of the girls because I just love the frocks.
That's fantastic. Thank you so much for speaking with me. Can't wait for everyone to see the show.